50 years after humans first walked on the moon, NASA is planning to return, with ESA as an integral partner. This silver capsule is Orion, the crew module, and below it is the European Service Module, or ESM, the European element that will make the journey possible. Orion and ESM are at the Glenn Research Center's Plum, Brook station in Ohio, USA, where they're undergoing a series of tests in readiness for their upcoming space flight.
We put it in the world's largest space simulation chamber. We pump all the air out of it, and then we give it the cold background of space, and we hit it with hot in certain areas to simulate being on orbit, no air, in the sun, very, very hot, in the shade, very, very cold. And then we hit it with radio frequency waves. So we simulate, for example, sitting on top of the rocket, on the pad, it gets pinged with radar, right, as it's sitting there. We run all the electrical systems, make sure everything continues to work despite being hit with these radio frequencies.
The Orion crew capsule was developed by NASA, who entrusted ESA with creating a service module to propel and power it, as well as providing life support. The ESM's technology builds on systems used in ESA's automated transfer vehicle, which ferried supplies to the International Space Station between 2008 and 2014.
It was described as being derived from the ATV on various aspects of avionics components. Of course, the function is different than ATV itself. It provides thrust from the propulsion system. It provides commodities for the crew, such as water, nitrogen. It provides all of the temperature control, so to keep the crew in good environments. It provides the electronic equipment as well.
The tests in Plum Brook Station will take 2 months, after which the lunar spacecraft will be transported back to Kennedy Space Center to meet its launcher, the newly developed Space Launch System, or SLS. Following ESA's recent Space 19+ ministerial conference in Seville, Spain, 4 European service modules have been budgeted for. The first uncrewed mission, Artemis 1, will launch the spacecraft into an elliptical orbit around the moon.
Artemis 1's success is very critical. We want this mission to be as perfect as it possibly can be. We want it to achieve all of its goals. We want everything to be perfectly safe because we want to make sure we say, yes, we are okay to launch people on the second Artemis.
Named after the Greek god Apollo's twin sister, the Artemis program incorporates a series of progressively complex flights for Orion and ESM. The third Artemis mission will put humans on the moon for the first time since 1972. A dream come true for everyone working on this ambitious program.
It's been a very long design phase and a lot of development, build-up of hardware, integration, assembly, testing. So it's a very challenging program, of course, but it is a big, big achievement, I believe.
After the tests at Plum Brook have been completed, Artemis 1 will be qualified for flight and ready to begin the bold space program that will see astronauts revisit our moon. Thank you.